Good morning, everybody. Sorry I'm late. One of the hazards of being home, I get to take care of my dogs. Not that it's a hazard, but it throws off my schedule sometimes because the dogs decide that they don't want to let me do a live video. Well, I hope you guys are enjoying the sampler quilt along so far. Here's my block two. Please post your blocks when you're done in the group, just so that we can see what they look like. Where are we gonna put this? We'll put it right here. How's everybody doing so far? Morning, Suzanne. Now, I know I promised that I would sew some of this third block together, but unfortunately, time was not on my side yesterday. I had a whole bunch of things I had planned, and I did not plan to be at the shop all day long. Not that that's a bad thing, it just kind of threw off my schedule. So, now we're going to be working on the third block, and anybody that was watching yesterday's video, disregard the first part that I put together, because you really need to put it together in bigger rows. Meaning, when I first did the quilt along, I put this part on. I sewed this part on to the center square, when actually you want to sew this together as one section. All of these, like in a plus sign, you're going to sew together. You're going to sew this together, all the four corners, and then you're going to put it together this way in three rows. So just to be sure everybody knows, I'm going to post today additional directions that I kind of clarified that on the second block. So I haven't had a chance. This third block is going to be put together the same way. So instead of this is block three. Instead of working from the center out, we're going to do just like I did in the second block. I'm going to do this section in the plus. I'm going to do the corners, and then we're going to put it together in three rows. One, two, and three. All right. Okay. All right. So, I think I'm going to tackle the small itty bitty half square triangles first. So I'm going to work on this part right here, and then I'm going to do these bigger half square triangles so I can put this section together, and then I'll work on this section. All right. How's everybody doing? Oh no, phone rang. See what you get to listen to with me being home? It's messed up. And I'm going to continue to sew these with a scant quarter of an inch. I think that works best on these. Ugh. If you guys need anything, you can message me, you can call, you can email me, and I'll see what I can do about helping you out. I've done a couple of deliveries. It's not something that I want to keep on doing, because I really don't know the area. And that would be local only, by the way. But for a few people that just can't get out for one reason or another, I'm willing to do a delivery. Can't say I'll do it immediately. Last night I was doing deliveries until about 7:30. But I'm more than willing to help you out as as much as I can. Oh, and there's a mask. I know everybody's doing the masks. I was supposed to do mine yesterday, but as you can see, by the time I got done sewing blocks together and things like that, it was after 10 last night. And the phone, why is everybody calling today? So I have a mask. I have a mask that I'm going to post a video for, a YouTube. Sorry, get to hear the answer machine. I have a YouTube video for a different mask that I think is much better that I will post today. It's by a woman that used to be a nurse. She's a retired nurse and she owns a quilt shop. And she does a really good job of explaining what things you should have in it and putting one together that I think is a little bit better than just the normal pleated mask that everybody's using or making. All right. So, and look what I did today. I know it's bright red. You can see it in the background, but check this out. If, for those of you who don't know, flannel makes a great design wall in a pinch. There you go. So you don't have to have anything fancy for a design wall, just some flannel. No, Suzanne, but I do have heat and bond lightweight, non-woven, fusible. If you're thinking of that for the masks, you can actually use that too. And I do have, I think about a half a bolt left. It's 20 inches. So here you go. This is the part I'm working on. I just did these two half square triangles and now I'm gonna sew these. So we'll sew these two together and we'll sew these two together. Make sure the seams are going towards this solid square so that you can put these two together and nest the seams. Is that what you're looking for, Suzanne? Or is that why you're looking for it? I can give you a call later, Suzanne, if you'd like, after I'm done. Yes, Suzanne, it'll work. Not heat and bond fusible that you do for appliques, but I have it in a box over here. It is a lightweight, non-woven heat and bond. So it's got like a film over it. And you can use that. I would actually iron it on both sides of the fabric, not the front of the fabric, but both pieces of the fabric that you're going to put together. So you would have a protection layer on one side and a protection layer on the other. I've seen some people putting batting in the masks, but think about it. And I didn't think of this at first either. I thought it was a great idea, but batting, even cotton, is gonna make it warm. So people are not gonna wanna keep it on for too long if they get too warm and sweaty. I'll post the video when I'm done with this video. It really is good. I thought she did an excellent job of explaining and she walks you through the whole steps of putting it together. It's one of those masks that covers everything right here. And the pattern that she points to is a PDF, and it's a great pattern because here's the kicker. It has different sizes on the pattern. So for a child age 3 up to like a woman or a young adult, and men. I think there's 4 sizes on it. Oh well. Anyway, you'll see it when I point to it. It'll be, I like it. I thought she did a really, really good job. Okay, so we're at this point. Now to iron these, because I want the seam to go on the solid part, make sure you set your seam with the solid on top. Does anybody have any other questions? And I know some of this stuff I just keep repeating, but I figure that way it'll sink in and it'll be easier for you. So, like I've been saying right along in all these videos, we have a lot of small pieces, so starch, you know, not regular starch. We use Mary Ellen's Best Press, which is a starch alternative, is really going to help you out a lot with these little pieces because it's going to stop them from stretching and going wonky. They'll go through the machine much easier. Okay, so here we are, and I'm going to set my seam. Nest my seam, I'm sorry. This is probably one of, not only, but few times that I actually pin, because I don't do a lot of pinning. I just never found a need for it. But I will pin to make sure my seams line up. I'm still amazed while doing the videos, the deliveries last night, how many times I saw people just kind of gathering in, you know, groups here and there, which I just don't get at all. Believe me, if I didn't have a business, I'd be in the house the whole time. I would not go anywhere. But unfortunately, I have to. Okay, I don't like... See, I'm not perfect, people. I don't like how that seam isn't lined up. I'm just going to, I'll leave it for now. Oh, no, I'm not. I'm going to quickly unstitch it just a little bit and fix it. But, you know, we've got these no gathering and executive orders for a reason. For me, it's a little bit more difficult. Most of the time, I'm just going to the shop and packaging orders by myself. So it's not that big of a deal. I am, you know, providing a little bit of curbside for anybody who is actually coming out or has to for the masks and things like that. I was able yesterday to help a nice young lady who works at one of the banks with all the stuff that she needs to make masks for all the tellers and things like that, which I felt really good about. But if we don't have to go out, I really, really would not recommend it. How's everybody else doing? All right, better. Tomorrow, I'm going to work on quilting our Stitch Happens Quilt Along wall hanging that we did last year. I doubt very much that I'm going to get the whole thing quilted tomorrow, so I'll probably do an additional video, but I think it's going to be fun. I'm looking forward to it, actually. I have no idea what I'm going to do on it yet. We're going to kind of wing it, see how it goes, but I'm doing it mostly with rulers, and I'll get to show you just a few things. It's not really a class. It's going to be more kind of like a demo and just something, a few ideas for what to do with it and how my brain thinks. I know, really scary thing. Nobody wants to be inside my head. Trust me. I'm surprised sometimes what comes out of my brain. Okay, now I'm going to do the big half square triangles, which is these right here on the side of this corner block, this corner piece. But as far as tomorrow, I think you'll enjoy it, even if you just, if you've never free motion quilted before. And I'll warn you, I have been quilting for a very, very long time. Piecing, I should say, not necessarily quilting. Because every time I have tried free motion, I just couldn't do it. I have a very difficult time. My head, my hands, and my feet don't all work together at the same time. Until I discovered rulers or what you would consider templates. Now, there's no holding me back. And once all this craziness ends, you can join. I have a once a month, like a block of the month, ruler work class. And you actually make an entire quilt with just free motion. Excuse me, I got a frog. If you have a chance to go over to the page, my Facebook page, you can see it if you haven't seen it already. It's probably the closest. I shouldn't say that anymore. You normally been saying it's probably the closest I will ever get to a whole cloth quilt, but that's not necessarily true anymore since I have the long arm. I think it's more of a possibility now than it ever has been. But it's really a lot of fun. I love being able to be as creative as I want and finishing a quilt from start to finish is amazing. And I know a lot of you can stipple. I couldn't stipple. It's just something that in me. I mean, I would literally draw it out. Even in my like row by row, and some of you already know this because I've said it, but my sky piece in my row by row is only about that big, and I stippled it. Well, on every single one that's hanging up in the shop, I've drawn it. I've actually drawn the stipples and stitched it and ripped it out, drawn it again, and restitched it. I'm terrible at it. I just can't. It just doesn't work for me. Having the rulers just takes one part of the equation, out of the equation. So it makes it much easier for me personally. And once I figured that out, forget it. I want to quilt everything. I'm not crazy. I probably would never quilt a king size unless it was on the long arm, but on your domestic machine, there's a good amount that you can still do and have some fun doing it. All right, so this is what we're working on. So this is one of my corners. So we've done this block here. Oh, you can't see it that way. Okay. We've done this block. I've done the two. Ah! Technical difficulties. This is what happens when you try to do all this at home, and I'm not comfortable at my shop. It's much easier. All right. Here we go. Okay. So I've done this part. We've done the two half square triangles. Now I'm going to put these two together. And then I'll put these two together. Now, traditionally, what I think I'm going to do is iron my seam towards the half square triangle on both sides. That way it'll give me one seam going this way and one seam going that way. And it'll make it much easier for me to nest the seams. Any questions? Does anybody have anything else they want to ask me? Not necessarily again about this project, but anything else? After I'm done with this video, I'm gonna print up some labels and be on the computer for a little bit so that I can post what I said I was gonna post. And then I'll be off at the shop packaging orders. So if you need me, you know where you reach me. Don't forget, everything is on sale 10% off, and for online orders, it's free shipping over $35. And get a free fat quarter surprise on a $35 order. So I've got my two pieces, my two little mini rows, and now I'm just going to nest the seams and sew them together. And that's what the four corners are going to look like, which is really easy. It's pretty much this, almost the same as what we did yesterday. So you should be able to do it. Once you've done it once, the rest of it's easy. Good morning, Kathy. How are you in Kentucky? This we're going to do one of the center pieces. Oh, I miss you too, Kathy. Are you keeping yourself busy? And everybody, I hope everybody in the family is good. For these, I would recommend ironing the seam towards the outside this way, just because I try to keep it away from the bulk where all these little tiny seams are. You don't want to bulk it up too much. you go. That's one corner. You only have three more to go. I'm not going to go through them all today just because of timing. Just making sure I have this together right. I don't know about you guys, but let me tell you, my days are running into each other like crazy. I'm losing time. I don't even know what time it is half the time. I don't know what day it is. I wake up in the morning and I literally sit there for a few minutes trying to figure out what day it is before I even decide to get out of bed. Okay. Sorry. I thought I silenced that. Okay. This is our centerpiece. And this, once we're done, will be in between two corner pieces like that. Kathy, what am I putting this on? This is just a piece of flannel. That's all it is. Flannel actually makes a great design wall in a pinch or in a hurry. That's all it is. If you really want to make a great design wall, insulation, the pink rigid boards of insulation or something like that. You could actually staple, obviously you don't want red, but that's all I had at the moment. Staple either flannel or like a flannel back vinyl tablecloth with the flannel part pointing out to it, and then just lean it up against the wall or tack it up against the wall, and you've got a design wall. All right, let's see. So, one more thing. I'm going to show you, for those of you who don't know, how I would sew this together, because I don't want Y seams, okay? So, if we put this together and then put this piece onto this one, see, we just have that one straight line. That's how you're going to piece them together. Same up here. We're going to put this purple piece onto the square. We're going to sew these two together, and then you'll be able to sew them together because you have one straight seam. Sometimes it's a little detective work in some patterns, especially in this pattern or in this design software. They don't give you written directions. They just give you a map. Let's start down here. And I missed your comment, Kathy. I'm sorry. I believe you said all the family's good. Oh, you're welcome, Kathy. Anytime. I had to try and do something. Originally, I wanted, when I was at the shop yesterday, to grab a, I have a stand, you know, to put boards on, signs and whatever, and I was gonna bring that. But I forgot. Like I said, I was not expecting to be at the shop as long as I was last night. Now, I'm thinking okay, I just did this first part. That's not going to stay like that. Okay. What I think I'm going to do, remember, we're trying to nest the seams. So I think this seam for this purse part is going to go towards the green. And this one will go towards the green. That'll give me a great opportunity here to nest. So what else is going on, everybody? I can tell you my dogs are loving having me home and having everybody home. Boomer especially is loving it. I think he's a little confused though, because it's kind of like, wait, is it the weekend? Kind of like what we're doing, trying to figure out what day it is. That's not good. I sewed the wrong side. Told you. This is what you get when I don't do the pattern, when I don't sew it together first. Unfortunately, I didn't have a lot of time to kind of put this together. So we're flying by the seat of our pants, and we're all sewing it. Hopefully we're all sewing it at the same time. Oh, I've got, how many of you are doing Bonnie Hunter's Unity quilt? Rose finished her first block. I have all my fabric here, but I haven't had a chance to do anything. That's like the story of my life. So I'll post Rose's block before I go to the shop today. I know Fran's working on it. I want to work on it. I stole all Fran's color ideas because I'm doing mine in blue, teals, and purple too. Go figure. It just came out so pretty when she did it. I really like how these stars are coming out. I've always loved stars. Stars and kaleidoscopes, can't get enough of them in quilts. That's that part. Now I'm just gonna put the purple triangle without blue and everything else onto this one we just sewed. And I'm gonna sew this one and we'll be ready to put them together. Let me make sure that I'm doing this right. If you were doing this at home, I don't pin very much, so I have a tendency to sew things on wrong. But I would highly suggest if you do pin, even if you don't pin, to put a pin where you're supposed to sew, so that from the time, you know, we're all getting older now, from the time you take it from here to lay it on your table to sew, you don't flip it around. I get myself in a lot of trouble doing that. You'd think I would learn, but On that one, I don't, because I don't like to pin as much. It's just the way I am. There's nothing wrong with pinning. It's just, I don't pin as much. And I'm chain piecing. I like to chain piece as much as possible. It doesn't seem like it saves time, but it does. What's everybody else working on? Are you working on, I'm assuming, masks? Seems like everybody's working on masks. I wish I could get my mask done. But what else? I know a few of you are working on Unity. Some of you are working on this. What else are you working on? And I am ironing this towards the purple, which I'll show you, because I know purple is not in the color. Oh, maybe it is. No, towards the pink on the pattern. Anybody done any bears? I know Joanne has. She sent pictures. Like, amazing. They are so cute. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, are Kimber Bears. Kimber Bell came up with the design, and I brought in the Minky, or the, actually it's called Luxe Cuddle Fabric, and was supposed to offer it as a free class. I ended up doing an online video because the first class was when all of this craziness started, and that wasn't happening. Okay, so I've ironed towards the purple on both sides, so I have an opposite seam here, and now I have an opposite seam on this side, which we originally sewed. So I'm just gonna nest these seams, sew them together. But those bears, if you're doing bears, post some pictures, please. I have to live vicariously through you, especially with all this craziness going on. So please post some pictures. I want to see what everybody's working on. All right. Now, I know I've said this before, and I'm going to keep saying it, so unfortunately, if you've watched all the videos or been here live, then this is just a repeat. See my dog ears? I don't very rarely, I don't want to say never, but I don't normally cut them off. Because most of the time, it's not that much of a bulk, but right now I'm sewing, if I was to sew on here, the dog ears would give me something to shoot for, because right in this V here should be where I need to start or end sewing. It's just, I mean, I know a lot of them tell you, cut your dog ears off, but everything I do is more timing. I don't have a lot of time to do anything. So if I can save time here and there, you know, a minute here, a little bit time there, it actually adds up pretty quickly. Most of the time, the dog ears aren't going to create that much bulk for me. One of the few times that I really do cut the dog ears off a lot is if I was doing a kind of like a stack and whack or a kaleidoscope where you're doing a lot of triangles and they're all going to meet in the center. I would cut the dog ears off then and try to cut out bulk, because that is a lot of bulk. But even then, I've figured out another way of doing it so I don't have to cut it off either. Kind of like with the Lone Star. And you've got all of those pieces coming into the center. You'll have 8 of them. If you make that seam at the end like 1/8 of an inch wider or smaller, it's not gonna bulk, and you don't have to cut anything off, and you're not gonna have a little nub at the end either. All right. Now I've ironed this seam up, and I'll show you what I mean. I may have to change that when I put, I'm gonna have to. Okay, I'm gonna iron that seam down, and I'll show you why in just a second. I'm always thinking about how I'm gonna put things together. So sometimes I have to change how I'm going to iron my seams just to make sure it goes together as well as possible and as easy as possible without any, not say any bulk, because when you've got something that you're piecing a lot of little pieces, you're going to get bulk. It's almost impossible not to in these blocks. That's why we're going to, I try my best to make sure my seams are going the right way. But when you've got a lot of little tiny pieces all around, it's almost impossible. All right, so now I have ironed it going down. Because I want these going up into all of this more or less empty space, not into the small pieced block, which will cause bulk. So that way, if this one is going up and this seam is going down, it'll make, even though it's on an angle, and actually, I'm gonna put this together for you. Just this one piece, because I wanna show you how to angle, how to make sure you piece these so that they match up perfectly. If you try to angle it and get this seam into this seam and nest them like we normally do, it's gonna be off every single time. And I do mean every time. So I am going to show you. It's the same method that I use for doing a Lone Star. This is a really good lesson for you. If you've used this method before, let me know. But most people haven't. So give me a second, and then that'll be the end of this video, because this is a quarter of this block. So once you put it together, all 4 corners and the center pieces, and I'll show you that. So once you put this corner and this center piece together, this corner, you do all of these pieces, it'll go together in 3 rows with no Y seams, no hassles, no nothing. So after I put this together, I will show you how to line those seams up, or at least try, because I wasn't thinking of doing it. But like I said, we're doing this all on the fly. At least if I know what I'm teaching, I can prepare a little bit better. But sorry, that's the phone. Even though it's on silent, it's vibrating. What's funny is being in here with Boomer sleeping, he snores. I'm amazed at how much that dog snores every day. All right. So there we are. Somebody's calling again. I don't know. All right, we're almost done. So, in order to piece these so that you get these lined up perfect, oh, not perfect, because there is no such thing as perfect, but pretty good, what you're gonna do is whatever seam allowance that you've used to piece these, you're gonna make that mark. So right now we're using a scant quarter of an inch. If you were doing a quarter of an inch, you'd put a quarter of an inch mark right on this seam and a quarter of an inch mark right here on this seam. You're gonna put a pin through your mark into the seam, and then through this mark and into this seam, and you're going to hold it so that the pin is up and down straight. Okay, come on. There's that, and there's that. Okay, so let me put my marks. And then I'll show you exactly what I mean. Hopefully you can see this mark. The only time that I use what I call glass pins is when I'm doing this type of work. And most glass pins have a little ball. Normally I use flat pins, but okay. Can you see the mark? All right. So now I'm going to put right through my mark and my seam here, put the pin. And right through my mark and my seam here. And the only reason we're doing it this way is because we've got an angle. We've got this angle coming down. Oops. And this will make sure it pieces perfect. Okay. And the reason I use the glass pin is that they're thinner. So, I know it's hard to tell, but see my pin? You can only see the head, and that's good because that means it's straight up and down. Reason I want it straight up and down is, and I don't want it on an angle up or an angle down, is because then you're not where you need to be. And then I'll take another pin and put it in the seam on an angle, and you can take the first glass head pin out. Now what this does is, and the reason I'm again on an angle, so I'm going to start sewing from this way down. By having this pin on this angle, because I'm sewing from here down, I can hit that seam with my needle down before I take the pin out. Sometimes just the function, I don't know what you want to call it, just the physical part of taking the pin out can jostle the seam. And then when you think you've done such a great job, and you go to look at it, it's not where you want it to be. All right, so now we'll see if I did it right. Now tomorrow when we do the ruler work, quilting, you're probably not going to see my face very much because I'll have the camera angled down. Or I might get really technical if I have time today and set up the new camera and switch. Oh, my pleasure, Phyllis. So maybe I'll be all kinds of IT guru and have two cameras tomorrow so that I can switch between my mug and what I'm going to be working on. Let's see the magic reveal. I'm going to look first. I'm happy with that. I'm very happy with that. Okay. You see? Now, this looks like one continuous line because I got it lined up exactly where I wanted it. Anybody have any question before I hang up? I'm going to be posting that YouTube video link for those new masks, which I really, really like. And again, for those that came in late, the mask and the YouTube was done by an ex-nurse who owns a quilt shop. And she goes through the do's and don'ts for what to put into the masks and what not to. And it's a really good mask, and she walks you through every step to actually put the mask together. So I think it's definitely worth it. Plus the pattern that she points to has, I want to say, four sizes, like 3-year-old to like teenager, young adult woman slash woman, and a men's size. So I think that is going to be great. Okay, so there you go. Now, all you have to do is do this 3 more times on each part of these and put your 3 rows together and then put your block together. Does anybody have any other questions before I call it quits? Okay, I'm going to be on the computer for a little while, trying to print up some packing labels and post those links that I said that I was going to. And tonight I will work on the YouTube video and hopefully get that up. All the first 2 videos for the star sampler are already on YouTube. I'll probably tweak them some more because I've been terrible with these videos. And then I'll be at the shop. I'm hoping to be at the shop just for a couple of hours so that I can come back here and work on some masks and a few other things, but God only knows. You're welcome, Suzanne. You're welcome, Kathy. So if there's no other questions, have a great day, everybody. Oh, thanks. Rose says she likes my hair. It's like all over the cake place. All right, everybody. Have a good day. You know where I am if you need me.